What's going on, people? Welcome to another episode of Creamwell Access as we take you behind the scenes with a very familiar car indeed, our Bentley GT. As you guys know, this car used to be owned by a previous client of ours, Rob Fume, who spent a hell of a lot of money having it fully customized for himself at the time, taking it from a Bentley GT to a Bentley GT Super Sport. As you can see, the full front end conversion with the bumpers, the rear bumper, we even cut and extended the rear arches to give it that genuine factory flair that the Super Sport has. We then went about customizing and fabricating our own carbon understeel kit for it, which you can see behind me, front lip, side skirts, and rear spats, including a rear tunnel that goes underneath the rear bumpers. We finished it off with the Onyx rear spoiler, a full carbon rear spoiler that goes in the boot lid, and that finished it off perfectly. As far as spoilers go for the Bentley GT, I felt that was pretty much the nicest one out there, so there was no need for us to actually make something, so we used something that was already out there. We lowered it then on drop links, took it down to its maximum as well, and you can see that behind me on its lowest setting. We then finished it off with 22 inch wheels, low profile tyres from our friends at Projects Design, who hooked us up back then. We've then given them a new look with a smoked lacquer tint on it. I'm going to now strip the wrap off and start again, give it a new colour. And it's been doing my nutting for so long now, because I just can't see the car in another colour. So we've done a test panel on the front, as you can see. And today we're going to be doing a few more test panels. We've got gold chrome on the other side. We've got rose gold to lay down today. And rose gold chrome, also by Hexis, to lay down on another panel today. And we're going to have a comparison. We're going to look around and see which colour suits the car most. My mind is telling me to go with rose gold chrome. It's just a colour that my mind is kind of set on rose gold, because mainly because of the fact that
my mind's telling me no.
Anyway, as I was saying before it was rudely interrupted, was that I'm swaying towards rose gold purely because of the fact that I absolutely love it as a colour. I always have done, and as you know, we've been recently doing a hell of a lot of rose gold wheels in chrome, which is a finish that that we've been proud to be able to offer out there, along with all the other chrome colours on the spectrum. But yeah, I mean, rose gold is a colour because of its subtleness. I love how subtle it is as a colour, but at the same time, it's very, very striking. But it's not loud as a colour, the rose gold. You guys have been amazing on Instagram and our social media that have been putting in your opinions. I've taken all of you guys' opinions on board. And you know what, it's weird, because it's kind of like 50-50 with your opinions. So many people love that colour, which is what I posted. The satin matte rose gold, and so many people love the gold chrome, which is on the other side. And if you come around, I'll show you. If you look, you can see that I've laid the new Hexis chrome gold down on the wing, and although it's a gorgeous color, extremely bright, it's not as subtle as this, and that's what I love about the gold chrome that's on this. That, yeah, obviously it's bright, very reflective and shiny, but it's pale, and because it's pale, I believe it gives it a much more of a subtle finish. This is so striking and loud, and so bright. It's like kind of like 9-carat gold, English gold, versus 24-carat Indian gold. So I'm excited to see what the rose gold looks like today once I lay that down. I'm going to put it along that panel there so we can have a really good comparison between the two. And I'll put the satin matte rose gold by Hexis on that side. Again, their chrome satin matte version. And then we will make a decision. I'll get the order placed with Hexis, yeah, man, I'm excited to get the car done finally, get the car looking immaculate again, and get it out there for the summer. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thank you. Alright, so we've just laid the rose gold and the satin chrome finish. What I can tell you, that it goes down like butter. Really nice to work with this stuff. The rose gold on. We've done the other side in satin chrome. And we're going to do this side in the gloss and then make a comparison. That's the idea. Okay, so after much deliberation, we have finally chosen a colour for the Bentley. There was a few colours in mind. We put on social media, and it was a toss-up between four colours, but satin chrome rose gold and gloss chrome rose gold was amongst our favourite. And for me, I finally settled with the gloss chrome. And as you can see here, this is one of the boxes that we got here. You can see why. It's a really, really strikingly gorgeous colour, and it's got that subtleness about it as well, which is what I was after. I do love the satin as well, and I hope to use it for a client or something one day. But with my car, I've chosen the gloss because it just provides that longevity, and it will go that further extra mile. And I just love that, you know, every 6 months or so you can flat it, you can polish it, and always keep it up to scratch, whereas on the satin side, any marks and scratches, you're kind of done for. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. We've had some great news also, as I've already discussed, we are going to be on the Guy Ritchie set for the movie, coming out soon. But we are also, at the same time, going to be at the Autosport Show International in Birmingham NEC. So stay tuned, and I hope you guys enjoy the video. And you guys can also get to see the car on display at the NEC.
This is a pain in the ass, but someone's got to do it. And I wish it wasn't me, but it is.
Okay, so it's strip time for the Bentley. First things first, we're going to get all of the chrome wrap off. Well, I'm not, Chris is. And as you can see, he's already started and got the roof stripped off. And once he does that, Paul's going to join him in getting the car stripped. Get the spoiler off, the light, all the trims, mouldings, mirrors, door handles, that sort of thing will have to come off the car again. and then Paul and Chris will carry on stripping the car down completely. The next thing will be to repair the damage that you can see here. I've done outside, as you guys may remember, with the lorry. Done a hit and run outside our workshop. Yeah, the wheels have been refurbed, so they're good to go. The idea is to get the car immaculate once the car's fully rewrapped with the refurb wheels. It'll be ready to put on the market and sold to its new lucky owner.
Right, so as you can see, I've moved on to a bonnet. Cash being cash and being extra special has double wrapped his bonnet in gold chrome and gold shimmer. As you can see, it looks nice, but it's to get off and it's a torture to your hands.
Okay, so the car is pretty much fully stripped. Chris has got a little bit more left to do on it. There's a few alterations that I'm making to the car. Just to update you with the new parts. We've got our new rear diffuser that's going on. Dave's just offering that on as we speak, and it actually fits a tree. Originally made for the GTR. This is a replacement rear diffusers for the GTR that go on all the OEM cars. Take out the factory one and just put this one in. But it actually fits the car really well, so we're going to get that mounted on, make sure it fits perfectly before we paint that, and we're going to modify the rear corner spats on the car as well, and yeah, get the car ready and prepped for that.
Kind of weighted the wing out nice and straight. Now the last little skim of filler into primer, ready to wrap it. Come direct and you can say, okay.
So today we've got the painstaking job of taking all the old glue from the old wrap off the car. It's a pain in the ass, but we will get there sometime today. Alright, so the next step is for me to split the lower front lip and the bumper apart so I can prep it, get ready for the boys to start wrapping it.
We're going to start wrapping the Bentley. We're going to take all the doors off and we're going to, so we can prep all the door shuts. Me and Cash, the vinyls just turned up and we are going to hit the quarters and the doors because there's a really short deadline on this one. And so Paul can start and Chris can start buttoning it back together. Ain't that right, Chris?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's just get the door.
That's right.
Let's get the door.
Coming live and up. Hurry up.
Outside the workshop where a truck driver reversed up to the back of the car and caught the back with his trailer part and caused extensive damage right here, and Paul's done a fantastic job of repairing that. It's still prepped and ready and prime, but obviously the car needs to be rewrapped because it can't be done in that gold that it was before, because it was done some time ago. And if you just wrap that section there, the colour would be quite off. Not even slightly, would be quite off. So for that reason, we have decided to strip the car, prep it, get the car ready. The boys have done a really good job in doing that. And today will be wrap day. We are going in rose chrome gold. It's a colour that I've always loved. Been around for quite a while now. And we've been exclusively offering that colour in paintwork. So I believe this will be the first Bentley, or the first car even in the UK, to have the super mirror finish chrome rose gold that's just been released by our friends at Hexis. It's an amazing chrome. It's been developed over the years now. It's been out, chrome's been out for some time, and Hexis have just gone and taken it to the next level by offering a super mirror finish chrome, basically meaning that it's like a mirror, the reflection in it, and this really is that. So the car's prepped and ready. Me and Tell, my right-hand man when it comes to wrapping, are going to be smashing it out today, hopefully get as much done as possible today, and then tomorrow with the bumpers and bits and pieces, and of course we'll be doing the small girly things. The boys are going to be working around the clock on this one, because we've had a major opportunity that's come through the door. A few of our vehicles are going to be featured in Guy Ritchie's upcoming movie, again another gangster film, and they need a few of our vehicles for one of their scenes, so amazing opportunity, again amazing news. So not one to be missed, of course. So we're going to be working around the clock. I'm going to be getting stuck in with my man Tell, get the car ready. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy the journey, and yeah, keep following. You tell, tell.
The mummy is right.
Mummy
doesn't hurt.
Mummy part four. Look at me. Look at his eyes. Hey, you guys.
Lovely.
What do you think of the colour, babe?
Very nice, it's my colour. I'm going to wrap my car in this colour.
Hi, are you going to help Daddy?
Hi, this is my pink car.
Okay.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, hey, look, who's that? Who's that?
Yeah,
okay, come, you're going to help Daddy, yeah?
Yeah.
Come then. You this one? This one? And you go like this. Oh. Oh, wow.
You're doing it all by yourself.
Thank you.
carbon pieces have been lacquered, come out very nice. Just need a little tickle over with a bit of 2000 and then a nice polish up to make the glass finish.
Day three, car's nearly complete. As you can see, the front bumper's on the car now. All the infills are done, tails in the background, doing the rear bumper. Not a lot left to do. Front bumper needs to be finished, rear bumper, and we can start fitting the car back up finally. The door shuts have been done, as you can see, and they look fantastic. I'm really happy with that. The doors are off and the trestles in the background as well, so the underside of the doors have been done as well. So today, the idea is that we're gonna fit the whole car back up, pulse finish the carbon undersill kit as well. Been polishing all morning, and that looks really good as well. Really happy with that. And yeah, the idea is that today and tomorrow we'll get the car, fit it back up. We're pretty much there now with it. Really happy with how it's turned out. The colour is absolutely amazing. And yeah, looking forward to the 14th, where we take the car down to the movie set of Guy Ritchie's new film called Tough Guys. Really excited for that. Oh, and we've also had some really good news as well with Hexis, who have provided us with this rose gold film, who have asked for the car to be on their booth at Autosport Show in January. So really looking forward to that. Lots going on. Giving it a final couple of coats of lacquer to make it look brand new again, basically. That will mean that literally every single car has been done. Not only has it been wrapped, all the carbon fiber body kit has been restored. It's getting a little bit fumey in here, so we make it out. Beats.
I get it.